Hello everybody, this is Manuel from the Materials Characterization Lab here at Penn State. I will be covering the subject matter that is metallography, which is the technical term for sample preparation. We have many pieces of equipment at our disposal, and depending on what your material is, as well as what characterization technique that will be used, will determine what the best solutions are for obtaining an adequate sample that will allow for a good data analysis. So researchers come in with different kinds of materials that require different sets of needs for their experiment. And because of this, there exist many manuals that specify what the best route for sample prep is, depending on what the sample material is. In reality, there is no written book on how to prep everyone's samples that will serve as a one-fits-all solution. So for that, expertise in the field is needed in order to cut down on time needed for trial and error that will determine what the best plan of action is. Luckily for us, we have many tools and equipment that may not all be covered in this presentation in order to minimize time spent on sample prep. Of course, there are trainings offered for users to get up to speed on metallographic techniques and to solve any problems they might be running into. Primarily, most of the users come in to use the polishing wheels. Now, we have different types of polishing wheels. They could either be manual polishing wheels that you hold the sample by your hand, or you glue your sample on a fixture and then manually polish the sample. And we have semi-automatic polishing machines so that you have better control of how much material you're removing. The semi-automatic machine, the one that we have, is the Allied Tech Multiprep. Can be calibrated so that you can have a flat surface, or if you need a TEM sample to have an angle to it, then you can set the angle to it as well. Now, if you have a bunch of samples that are mounted in epoxy, you can use the automatic polishing machine that is the Allied Tech MetPrep 3. This machine can hold up to 3 samples at a time and is programmable. So all you need to do is set the parameters such as RPM for the platen speed in the head, water usage, any other parameters that are necessary, what the pounds force is, and you set it up and hit go. And the good thing about this is you can crank out a bunch of samples at one time. Just as an example of what typical users are trying to achieve, here we have a 316 stainless steel. That goes from a 320 grit paper that's been ground down all the way down to a fine polished iron milling average surface roughness of about 7 nanometers. So we can see that range. On to your right of the stainless steel, we have an optical profilometry surface roughness measurement. And the very top one will have a 210 nanometer surface roughness. So it is very important to see what the surface roughness will end up looking like. Depending on the different applications, it is very crucial to have a smooth surface roughness, and therefore we'll need to have all the equipment available in order to tackle on this problem that some users might be facing. One example would be for a metal, we would like to see EBSD grain mapping capabilities. Well, if it's not smooth enough, then we can't get any Kikuchi bands. So it is very crucial to have a smooth surface. So I mentioned the iron mill. The iron mill is an ionized argon gas that has, this machine has 3 guns that are in a cross pattern. Essentially, this is a broad ion beam. There's a focus ion beam. Now we have a broad ion beam. The good thing about this is argon will not, typically does not tend to react with any of the samples, surfaces. And if there are any coatings, such as something in the nanometer range, this is perfect for removing that coating while not damaging whatever the substrate is. This is also great for that extra final polishing step. Sometimes in the mechanical polishing step phases, there are still some scratches and some surface waviness going on. There's not a really flat surface that's necessary. So we will turn to the iron mill. You know, for the stainless steel example, the sample would typically stay in for about an hour. So not too long, but again, depending on the material, how much material you're trying to remove will dictate how much time you'll be spending on the iron mill. The good thing about the iron mill is that you can set it up, hit go, and walk away and come back until the time is up. Here we have the Leica EMTXP. This is another polishing wheel, hybrid, if you will. It is great for small samples. There's a 10 millimeter diameter polishing wheel that is attached to this machine, and you can manually polish samples in an upright, vertical direction. Instead of traditionally, you have a wheel horizontally, and you apply a pressure to your sample. Well, this one, you can be more careful with how much pressure is applied to your sample. Leica sells these two pieces of equipment together. They try to advertise it. So it's pretty much a quick polish with the Leica EMTXP. You pop it in there, polish your sample, and then later you would be able to put it in the iron mill so that you can get a final smooth surface finish. We have precise and accurate methods of cutting capabilities here at MCL. We have an ADT Provectus dicing machine. This is perfect for samples that are less than 4 millimeters in thickness. Great for cutting wafers that have devices on top of them. This machine actually has a microscope that you can actually check to see where the cut has been placed. You can map an area and replicate this again and again for many samples. On the bottom, we have an ATM Brilliant 220. This is for bigger samples, rods of metal, chunks of plastic. This is also programmable. Essentially, this is a CNC machine, but with a dicing blade instead.